Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about the new LTE CAT-M1 and NBIOT enabled GPS tracker we designed for the UK market. This device is based on the valtrack-gcp device and has everything similar except a few changes. This device was designed based on the client requirement who needed a GPS tracker to connect with the Google Cloud platform by MQTT, and they wanted us to design a NBIOT capable device. For this purpose, we selected the SIM7000E module by Simcom. And this 7000E will serve the purpose for European and Asian regions. And for USA, we can use the SIM7000A module. So the SIM7000A module will support the NBIOT and CAT-M1 bands in the North American region. The SIM7000E specifically has a 2G fallback option, which can be used in case the NBIOT network is not available, which will be very useful because in India still the NBIOT network is not available, and we have tested this device on the 2G network itself. So the network connectivity part of the puzzle was resolved. Next phase is the power supply selection part, which was supposed to be derived from a 12 volt vehicle battery, and we selected this MP1584 switching regulator, which will reduce the 12 volt input to 5 volt needed by the circuit. And again, this 5 volt will be reduced to 4 volt by this regulator here. This regulator will convert the 5 volt to 4 volt at 2 amperes of current. So the GSM model SIM7000E will run on 4 volt, and the remaining circuit will run on 3.3 volt given by this little LDO here. So this LDO will give the necessary 3.3 volt needed by the microcontroller and other circuit like the accelerometer and the EEPROMs. Now coming to the MCU selection, we had different choices, but we chose the STM32L451 series MCU for this application because we needed to get the device connect to Google Cloud IoT Core. Google Cloud IoT Core supports MQTT with TLS 1.2 encryption. So we had seen this MCU run the TLS library given by ST Microelectronics. So we knew for sure that this chip can comfortably handle it, and that's why it was selected. The board has LS3D accelerometer by ST Microelectronics, which will be helpful for adding motion sensing capabilities to the device. We added the SoC package EEPROM on board to save configuration data. This EEPROM has enough space to save the GPS pings and later forward it on network disconnection. The footprint is compatible with the FRAM chips too, and in case we need to save data at a higher rate, an FRAM chip can also be utilized. The GPS module is the SIM39EA, which is used in the Valtrack devices, and it's also compatible with the mobile tech made N39 as shown here. So these are footprint compatible GPS devices, and the commands are also compatible. The data arrives in a similar fashion too. The very important addition to the board is the USB to UART converter. We added a Silicon Labs CP2102 chip. It's a very nice chip with very less external components, and provides the possibility of connecting the board to the PC for configuration. The MCU has 4 UART ports, among which one is routed to SIM7000, the other to the GPS, and the third one is connected to the CP2102, which makes communication to the PC possible. This USB port below the board will help in parameter configuration and data viewing for debugging purposes. A series of LEDs are available for general purpose usage. There were some GPIOs left which we have routed to the LEDs here. The cellular antenna is a SMA antenna used here, but a UFL connector is also provided, which can be used for connecting flex antenna as used in V2 and V2B for size constrained applications. SIM7000E uses 1.8 volt IO levels on its UART and GPIOs. So we added this TXS series 1.8 volt to 3.3 volt level translator for IO level conversion between MCU and module. A push-push type nano SIM connector is added here for easy SIM insertion and removal. Two power MOSFETs are added for turning the GSM modules on and off. Since the SIM7000 has inbuilt GPS option, we left the GPS antenna of the module routed to this SMA connector for future use with an external active antenna. Once we got the boards assembled, we got them up and running in no time with the bare metal core used in Valtrack series devices. But we needed to use the GCP library given by ST Micro, which made use of the embed TLS and a lot of other code for connecting to Google Cloud platform. on TLS 1.2 encryption. We did try this SDK initially, but it had a whole lot of problems doing the encryption. Then we found some commands that will make the SIM7000D handle the TLS encryption part. So we just used the encryption library for JWT generation and left the TLS handshake and encryption to SIM7000 module. The software worked flawless after about 15 days of development. The ES256 keys were used instead of the RSA256 as the generated keys and certificates were much smaller compared to the RSA generated keys. The encrypted connection does make the packets reach slowly to the server, but it's acceptable. The Google Cloud platform expects you to send the JWT, which is the JSON web token, as the password field in the MQTT connect packet, and the device ID path is the client ID. You can find these details on the Google documentation site. SIM7000 modules have inbuilt MQTT commands, which we thought of testing, and we tried the inbuilt MQTT commands, and we found that they are useless for GCP because the JWT cannot fit into the 128 byte limited password field of these inbuilt commands. Then again, we had to resort back to normal TCP communication and forming the packets ourselves. Now the device works fine on 12 volt and 28 4 volt inputs, and there is a reverse polarity protection diode added here too, which I forgot to mention. This is the third device in the SIM7000 series. First was the OBD tracker, which used the SIM5300E, which can be replaced with SIM7000E because they are pin compatible. Then we made this 7000E board for a requirement for UAE. Then this is the third one. I have tested this device to work with the Vodafone NBIOT network when we recently visited to the Bangalore testing facility. If you are interested in this device, then you can drop me a mail to ravi@valtrack-gcp.com and I can answer your queries regarding this device. And if you have any technical questions or regarding any of the topics, NBIOT or any of the modules, then you can ask it on embeddedadvice.com forum. That's all for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe.